Okay, so you guys remember the last video? The elevator with the door that wouldn't close, and the window that I pointed out to open. Unfortunately, oh, it's already here. Basically, this can be a little bit tricky. If you try walking or walk at the wrong angle, you'll just fall to your death. So just make sure you've got the open door before you make a jump. And there we go. Now, there is a chest, I think, over here on the far side. Yes, there is. Okay. That's the Chalice Dungeon item. We're gonna go with Ludwig's, just because it brings on the pain. And that thing here, you basically farm these for good blood gems. Ooh, that could have gone badly. There we go. Make sure your sedatives are handy. And cursed tempering blood gems. So they're basically. Oh! Ooh, just in time. They're basically the best ones you can get at this point. Obviously, when you do New Game Plus, you can get better ones again. Yeah. So there's one of those guys here. There's two more in the next area. There we go. Okay, so we can take those guys out. Let's wait for this one to come a bit closer. I'll just wait until my frenzy goes away, which it's not doing. Okay. Oh, so they drop bullets as well. So if you guys have the eye runes, oh, another tempering blood gem. They're basically going to help you get good drops from those guys. So if you're farming just blood gems, just walk back and rinse and repeat. But we're going to go get our blood rock. Now these are some crazy spiders with normal persons. Ooh. Yeah. Sorry, kind of concentrating. I'll tell lie, I think there's one more of those crazy eye things up ahead as well. But first, I think there's some more spiders and then a switch. And you guys remember that early when we first came here, there was that great big thing that basically that great big light that gave us frenzy. Well, it's time for some payback. We're gonna pull on this switch and kiss goodbye to the Metroid. Yeah, creepy looking motherfucker. Fall down into the depths of nothing. Okay, we can actually go visit that guy later on, which we shall do, but not right now. Alright, drop down here, and some spiders. So let's take them out. Nothing taken out ourselves. Okay, there's creepy eye thing. That's the way to the blood rock, but we're gonna go over this side first because I'm pretty sure there's a chest. Oh no! Stupid camera angle, fuck me over. Okay, so just bear in mind that the crazy camera angle is gonna fuck you over later. So, don't do what I did. Why the fuck did that happen? Okay, so that was stupid because I had heaps of stamina left, but for some reason I didn't attack. So, anyway, let's get this chest, and then we'll go get a blood rock. Cry bells, that's some kind of spell. Okay, so I tried to use that path here, so I was further away. But basically, that bit sticking out here made the camera move, so I walked off and died. Oh, hiccup. Okay, lots of madman's knowledge around here, so just make sure you check it all out. And those of you who are paying attention in the Mikalash video will know that we got a key. Ooh, arcane gem from the gem. And basically that key comes into play just beyond this range of corpses. Any more items? No, that doesn't seem to be. That is where we... Oh, no. Oh, I wonder if we can drop down there. Maybe not. Might just be for looks. Anyway. Down here. Let's check around this corner. Yep. Blood tinge. That'll be good for Evelyn. Evelyn's knowledge. And this is the gate we open with the key. And that takes us back to where we first saw Mikalash. So before we do that, let's go get our blood rock. And then the agonizing choice between the saw cleaver and Ludwig's. I say agonizing. I'm going to pick Ludwig's. I love this weapon. Okay, make sure you don't drop needlessly because you might drop into the pit and die. Drop to the side. Grab this item. Boom! Blood rock. And that's it. Okay, level 78. Take 9,256. That's a slight exaggeration. I'm hoping we can kill this fucker this time. You need to remember that he likes to use his gun when he dodges. When he's got his two-handed version of his sword, he can't use his gun. And he generally likes to charge after he first uses it. Oh, that so should have been a visceral for him. I'm glad that it didn't happen. Oh, that gun is so overpowered, it's not even funny. So when he's got his normal gun out, you just want to strife. It's when he's got his two-handed version that you want to be a bit more aggressive. Okay, keep that out. Come on. That didn't work. I should have equipped some numbing mist. Oh, you and your stupid gun. I wish I had that gun. Come on, come on. Cannon your face. What you think of that? Ooh, nearly got me, you fucker. His thing. Come on. Countered my OP gun with his own OP gun. Striping. Oh, what the hell? That didn't work out for anybody. I had that many blood bullets as well. Didn't have enough. Oh. Come on. Yeah, got you finally. Now we can go finish Eileen's quest, Blood Rapture. That does something with visceral attacks, I think. Phew! That was a lot tidier. I feel like I probably could have done that at 61 if I knew everything about him that I know now, but never mind. Nope. Super! Okay, so that's Eileen being all badass. And basically, when we come back, she's not there anymore. I can only hope she decided to move on and wasn't eaten by some kind of ghoul. But basically, that gives us the Covenant badge for her Covenant, the Hunter of Hunters. I think it increases your stamina regeneration. She also gave us the Crow Hunter badge, so we can buy her gear, as well as the Blades of Mercy, which are pretty good weapons, especially for PvP. Anyway, hope you guys enjoyed. Leave a like and subscribe, and we'll see you next time.